Hey guys, so today I am here for yet another video for you all, and this is going to be my January favorites. January was a really good month for me. I hope it was great for you guys as well. It went by not super fast, but semi-fast. December is what went by fast for me, because it feels like I was just standing here like last week filming my December favorites, and now I'm already here doing January. But it's a gorgeous day outside, and I'm wearing short sleeves, so obviously it's pretty warm, and I decided to film outside today because the lighting was good and it feels great, so get pumped for this video. But I hope you all enjoy this, and let's go ahead and get started with my favorites. Okay, so I'm going to start off with my brush favorites. I have one eye brush I really like to use this month, and it was my EcoTools Blend Brush, which came with like five other eye brushes from them. It just pretty much looks like that. It's kind of stiff, but it's very dense, and I really, really liked it for applying my brow bone highlight. I just found that it worked really, really well and packed on the shadow nicely. The next one is like one of my favorite all-time brushes. I got this brush for Christmas, and this is the e.l.f. Studio Small Stippling Brush. Oh my goodness, this brush is amazing. I'm not a big fan of regular stippling brushes for like applying face makeup or whatever, because I just find they don't work that well for me, but this one here is amazing. It's really, really dense, so it's not super like flimsy, and I have used this legit every single day for applying my under eye concealer. It works so well and blends it out so nicely, and this brush is just fabulous, and you can't beat the price because it's only $3. Like, this is excellent. My last two face brushes are from Coastal Scents, and the first one is this Coastal Scents Angled Blush Brush. I don't know like what size this one was. If I remember, I'll link it down below. But, oh man, it's getting windy. But basically, I used this a ton this month for applying my blush, and I actually started wearing some bronzer this month, and it works really well for both of those, and it's pretty dense, but it's also really soft as well, and it just applies my blush and stuff like that really beautifully, and I really like this brush. My last one is also from Coastal Scents. Their brushes are like really amazing. The price is really affordable, but it's also very high quality. And this is the Coastal Scents, I think it's called like the large powder brush. I don't know, but it says Coastal Scents down here, and it just pretty much looks like that. It's really big and fluffy, soft, dense, all those kind of things. And I really liked applying my powder with this, just dipping it into the powder and just popping it onto my face basically. And it worked really well, and yeah. Okay, so now I am going to do my eye favorites. Eyes are like my favorite thing in the world to do on a day-to-day basis. Excuse this line right here, like the sun is making my camera do something weird, but eye products are like my favorite thing in the world, but I only have three to share with you guys this month. The first thing is an eyeliner, which you guys might see in a collective haul sometime soon, and this is the Revlon Colorstay eyeliner in the shade brown. I never thought I would want a brown eyeliner, but recently I just started craving one, so I went to the store and I bought this one. It wasn't super expensive, but I also got it half off. It's super duper pigmented, like let me show you. And it doesn't smudge too easily, but I really like it. It lasts a while, and I've been using this like crazy this month on my waterline. And it's just a lot less harsh than using a black, and it goes great with like any eye look that I like to do. Whether it's more dramatic daytime look or more natural, it just works really well, and yeah, I definitely recommend this eyeliner to you guys. You should check it out. Okay, next thing is an eyeshadow by Urban Decay. And if you guys watched my Christmas haul, you might have already seen this. But I used this a ton during the beginning of January. I was fixing to say December. But I haven't used it much here recently, but it was a big favorite of mine in the beginning of the month. First off, the packaging is super duper cute. It just looks like that. And this is called Midnight Cowboy. It's a pretty natural color, but it has loads, loads, loads of glitter and sparkles in it. So if you don't like glitter, I would not recommend this. But I use my finger to apply this shadow, and sometimes I use a base. But I definitely do my eye makeup first and then my face makeup so I can wipe under my eye and remove all the fallout. But this is a gorgeous color, and it's a great go-to shade of mine, and I highly, highly, highly loved it for the month of January. Next thing was a palette, obviously by no surprise to you guys, and just take a guess, okay? Comment down below if you guessed what palette it was before I brought it up, and I want to know. Okay, it was the Urban Decay Naked 2 palette. Yes, finally, I feature this in a video. People have been requesting tutorials with this, and that will be coming soon, definitely. But I love my Naked 1. I love my Naked 2. I have, like, a baby Naked family in my house. But this palette is amazing. I love all the shades in it. Look, there's my tripod. Hello! But they're just gorgeous shades. Not really any in particular that I liked more than others. But they're all so beautiful, and yeah, I just love them all. They're very pigmented, very beautiful, and And today I am wearing Verve and Pistol on my eyes, in case you guys were wondering. And then Foxy as a highlight and Booty Call as a highlight on my inner corner. But it's beautiful and this palette is awesome. I always bring my products out to show you guys in a purse, and I just found an eyeshadow from my last favorites video in there. Wow. Alright, so we're now going to move on to face favorites. Now, seriously, excuse that line. Where is it coming from? Like, what is happening? I don't know, but we're going to move on to face favorites, and the first thing is a foundation, and I know I still recently got this, but I have to say I really do like it. It's the CoverGirl Oil Control Clean Foundation. I really like this. If you want to see my pros and cons of it, check out my blog, which I will link below, and if you guys want to see my first impression of it, then definitely check out that video. I might do a separate review of it in all, so I don't have to mention too much about it, but basically I have used it a lot this month since I got it, and I really like it so far. Okay, next is a powder. I know you guys are like, oh my gosh, CoverGirl powder. Yeah, we know. Stop showing it. No. Okay, this is a translucent powder, actually, and it's by NYC. Everyone here on YouTube says high-end translucent loose powder to the cheapest drugstore one you can find. It's all the same. This is my sister. She never uses it anymore, so she said I could have it, and I started using it to set my under-eye concealer, and it makes the biggest difference. Seeing how I use concealer to brighten my under-eye rather than, like, disguise my dark circles, it also helps brighten it because it is translucent. It's not adding excess color. But this is the NYC, or New York Color, Smooth Skin Loose Face Powder in the shade Translucent. It's really inexpensive. You get a lot of product in there, and I have just been loving this. Oh my gosh, there's a Chad. Hey Chad. Oh, he's hopping through my yard. Chad, come in my video. He's playing on my playground. Aww. But basically, I love this for setting my under eye concealer, and yeah. Next thing is a bronzer, and this is my mom's bronzer. I've only used it for like the past week, but I was like, you know what? I'm going to show this in my favorites video. I started wearing bronzer again this month, and I'm kind of wearing it today in my contour spots, in case you guys might can tell. I don't know about this lighting, because I can hardly see my viewfinder right now, but hopefully this lighting is good. And this is my mom's. I'm thinking about purchasing it for myself because I really like it. It's a matte mineral bronzer by Rimmel, and it's called the Rimmel Natural Bronzer, and this is in 21 Sunlight, and there's not much to say about it, but it just pretty much looks like that, and it's not super duper pigmented, which I like, so you can build it up, but I really like it, and like I mentioned, I might buy this for myself. Okay, last face thing is my favorite blush of all time, and I mention this in every video, pretty much, but I want to mention it in this video again because I really went hardcore on it this month, wearing blush every single day, and I found a new technique of applying it and stuff like that. But I just want to mention the product real quick, and this is my MAC Mineralized Blush in Dainty. It is beautiful. Oh my goodness. It has the slightest amount of shimmer in it to where it gives you a nice glow. It's really pigmented, it's buildable, and yeah, I just use this a ton this month. I only have one lip product to share with you guys, and that is my Kors Lip Butter in Jasmine. These are really nice and pigmented, and they are buildable. They're very moisturizing, and this one here is just like a light pink shade, which I have been wearing a ton on my lips. And that pretty much completes this month's favorites videos. If I have any random or food favorites, they will be in the description box down below, along with my Twitter and all that good stuff. So be sure to read down there after you finish this video. I'll see you guys soon. Thanks so much for watching. I love y'all so much. Bye! And be sure to tell me your favorites in the comment section as well.